My name is Jerry Ferrugia.
Herman Valoria.
My name is Rosalie Avila.
My name is Rick Rodano.
I'm Brooklyn.
I'm Sophia.
I am Brother Alejandro. I belong to the Missionaries of Charity Brothers. This is a congregation founded by Mother Teresa of Calcutta. And we have been here in Los Angeles for more than 30 years, yes, close to 35, something like that. We prepare sandwiches. Now we are preparing more or less 1,200 sandwiches every Saturday. Then after preparing them, and also we prepare some pastries, cookies, things like that, donuts, and then we bag them individually. And then after we finish with that, we go into the streets into six different routes, and we deliver this food for the homeless.
She used to be up at the park by Union Station.
Okay. What happened? You okay today?
I'm okay. Are you okay? I mean, last week you were kind of grouchy, wasn't that you? Oh no, that was me.
When I got involved here originally back in the early 80s, I was working at a church as a youth coordinator, young adult coordinator, and we started bringing the kids down here. Then I took a break when I got married and started having kids, and when my kids were a little older, we started bringing them back here about 10 years ago or so.
When did you begin volunteering with this organization?
1988.
And have you been doing it consistently since then?
Every Saturday.
Because once you've been here the first time, there's no way you can turn your back on it. Once you've been touched by what happens here, you just feel compelled to keep coming back.
I continue doing it because I feel these people look forward to having us there each and every Saturday. Even though it's just, you know, a sandwich, a cup of tea and a donut, but it's not so much about the food as much as the love that they feel we're bringing to them.
You know, most people think of homeless as these dirty people that live on the street and they've, you know, made bad choices and that's why they're here. But what has been very surprising to me is the way they live. Their areas are clean. They have a broom and a dustpan next to their entrance. You know, not all of them, but a lot of them do. And the other thing is that they take care of each other. If there's somebody new that comes into their group, they'll make sure that you know that they're there so you can offer them food. They tell you which people to stay away from. So I just think within their own little community, they have very special bonds.
There's Birdman. Birdman is a guy in our route, and every time he sees us, he just starts jumping for joy. He's like, "I'm so glad to see you guys," and he talks about how he's going to Santa Monica one day, or he's going to go to Disneyland, or all these cool things. And he talks about like his family and like people that he like pass by him, or like he makes fun of other people that pass by. He's a character. Yeah.
Why do you guys call him Birdman?
That is what he calls himself.
We're doing this in the tradition of Mother Teresa, as we all know, who founded the Brothers. We're here to give food and companionship and warmth and acceptance. They have enough bad stuff happening to them out there, so as you greet them, smile, because they don't see many smiles. They really need them. As you come up to their place of living, whether it be a cardboard house or just a blanket on the street, respect it as you would your own home. It is their home. And respect them. Don't ask how they got there or why they're there is nobody's business except theirs. You're just here to love them and accept them. Mother Teresa said, don't worry about how many people you help. Start with one and start with the one closest to you. So that's what we're doing. We're dealing with it in a small community way. And it does blossom out, the ripple effect.
They still run like the olden days. You better know it.
They do most of the work.
Mother Nature don't like that. Hey.
I heard a sermon. Father said something that we always kind of treat people not to say below us, not to say that they are not as clean as us. Always tell them or us or treat them as them and us. Who are them and who is us? We are all the same.
Because at the end, we are learning and they are learning, and at the same time that we are doing this, most of the times we are giving away something, which is very simple, but we are getting the more. We are getting so much love in our hearts when we do this. We are getting recognition by them, appreciation, and we are getting a lot of things when we do this, which is very simple, but we are getting huge things that are kind of invaluable things when we do this. And most of the volunteers agree with that, no? That what they have received doing this is much more than what they have done, what they have given away in their lives.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for being here. God say what's impossible for men is possible with him, but through the people that are working for him.